came to this strange world hoping I could learn a bit about how to give and take. Since I came here, felt the joy and the fear, finding myself making every possible mistake. La 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 la.
My name is Torkel. Adil asked me to participate in this outdoor show, and normally I don't do any outdoor sculptures, so I had to do something. So what we did, we actually did in 3 days. It's basically a heart and an arrow that goes into the heart. The title is Hit in the Heart. That's what Matrimandir do, that it hits you in the heart. It's an allegory of a old Greek god, Amor, which were able to shoot arrows into people and they will fall in love. So this is a play with that.
So this is the 50th year of Auroville, and as part of the celebration for the 50th year, I approached the Matrimandir group to host and to curate an exhibition of Auroville art somewhere on the Auroville campus, the Auroville ground. This was one of the spots shown to me. This is called the Boulder Garden. And initially when I saw this place, I was like thinking maybe these boulders are too strong, that they're visually very imposing. It still felt like a good spot to have a show, like an outdoor show. So I approached Auroville artists and we came up with this idea of Golden Sunbeams. This will be a show that will happen 4 times in this year. The idea was to bring in Auroville artists who work with different media and who would somehow respond to this topography, to the landscape, to whatever is here, and then add to it.
Hi, I'm Sabrina Shenevas. I am very happy to have my pieces as part of the sculptural exhibition of the Matrimandir. The two pieces that are being shown here are part of a series that actually first came to me when I was in Hampi as part of a ceramic residency. And there I was inspired by the boulders and forms that I saw around me.
From my side, I have two pieces which are made at my studio, Mandala Pottery. One is this one behind me, there's another one which is in porcelain behind. I call these rock flowers. I wanted them to look like they were springing out of the rocks. Some of these pieces are fired in a soda kiln, which is what I do at Mandala. Some are gas fired, so there's a kind of variation in the look of the pieces. There is also a book which I have here, which is made out of mixed media, which is a collaborative work with Alexi, who's also from Auroville. He works with recycled material and puts together things without actually buying material from someplace. Hank, who is a sculptor, he has got two pieces. There's one metal piece here in stainless steel, polished steel, and there's another blue piece at the side.
If you look carefully at all the pieces, you will notice that I'm the only person who didn't have the ready-made piece to bring. So I had to really look around and see what I can do in collaboration with rocks and trees and whatever we have in this spot. With this work, I was trying, and it was not my first and hopefully not the last chance to try, to change the atmosphere of the space in the direction of making it high. So my, we can't call it a piece, but this installation is called Sacred.
As you can see, these forms, they resemble tombstones. And how much ever I don't want to associate these forms with death, they do associate with death. India has a lot of association with this form, like a stone which goes on the fort on top, and also the milestone, also the stone on which you can grind. In South India, they grind chutney. Once I was traveling to Madhya Pradesh and I saw almost about thousands of this stones in one site. Just the visual of it, just so many stones put together in memory of so many people, just evoked some kind of very, very strong emotion in me.
So when Adil contacted us for this show, for this installation, I was immediately very enthusiastic about it because this particular place has a long history for me. When my kids were small and even before, we used to play in the evenings here in the Boulder Garden. So I chose this work here, which is called Aspiration, because I thought it fits in this place and it shows my feeling for this place, which is a light, transparency, a movement in the wind, a constant reforming of the shape through the wind and through the light, and a balance, an equilibrium. And I was very happy to work with the others, who I of course all know, but we rarely actually work together. So this, to come together here in the center of Auroville and work together, was a special experience for me. And that's it.